Good morning to all you awesome people. I welcome you all on our YouTube channel, JPSC Simplified. Let's crack JPSC. So my dear friends, continuing our series of art and culture of Jharkhand, today we will study food and jewelry of Jharkhand. Okay, so let's begin with the food of Jharkhand. See, water, forest and land, that is in Hindi, Jal, Jungle, Jameen. These three things are tribal heritage of Jharkhand. This is their identity. These are the integral part of their lifestyle and their culture. This gives life to their existence. These people who are in the lap of nature fulfill their needs only from nature. For centuries, their profession has been cultivation in the fields, paddy, marua, gondali, corn, gangai, urad, gram, jatangi, sariguza, peanuts and sugarcane are cultivated. Periodically, some fruits of the forest and flowers also become part of their food items. Okay. Now, festival, you know, plays a very important role in the lives of the people of India and also in the life of the people of Jharkhand. It is an integral part of human society. Tribal society is also not untouched by them. Festival means worshipping your divine. Also, it also means some special dishes. So today we are going to discuss some traditional vegetarian dishes that make up tribal households. Okay, so first we are going to see dishes made from rice. See, you don't have to remember the ingredients or the method of preparation of the dishes. Just you have to remember that this dish is a rice dish. This following dish is made of wheat or you can be given a question in the examination like dhuska. So they will ask you that what is dhuska, whether it is a dish, whether it is a jewelry, whether it is some other thing. Okay, so you should know that what is dhuska. So dhuska is a dish. So this type of question is generally asked in PCS examination of other states, and I think this type of question will be asked only in the prelims examination if it is asked in JPSC. So majorly what you should know, that this thing is a dish or some other thing, that you should remember. Okay, so let's see. So first dish that we should know is dhuska. Dhuska is a very popular in tribal homes. See, this is a dhuska. It is made up of rice. See, arwa rice and urad dal. Okay, so basically you can say that it is like a idli or a dosa, but made in some other style and it is deep fried. Okay, so I think this much is enough you should know about dhuska. Now the second one is your chirka or chilka roti. Again, it is made up of your rice. It is like a pancake, or you can say a Jharkhand version of dosa. And it is also made up of rice. Okay, then we have our dhubni roti. Again, it is made up of rice. Then we have rice dhuttu. It is also made up of rice. In the name only it is given that rice dhuttu. Okay, and then we have the other dish as pitha. It is also very famous in West Bengal. It is famous in Jharkhand, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh. Okay, so pitha, it is a rice dish, and this dish mainly it is made by people during the occasion of Makar Sankranti. Okay, that falls on 14th of January. Then, so this were your rice dishes. So let's see again what are the rice dishes we have seen. First dish that we saw made of rice was dhuska. Second, we saw about chilka or chirka roti. Then we saw about dhubni roti. Then we had rice dhuttu, and lastly we had pitha. So these five were the rice dishes of Jharkhand, and that you should remember. Now the second we will study about the dishes made from madrua. Okay, in that first we have madrua chirka. From the name you can decipher madrua chirka, made from madrua. And then we have chilka roti. In the rice dish also we have seen chilka roti. In the madrua dish also we are seeing chirka roti. Okay, then we have thapaya roti. What? Thapaya roti. Then we have latta. Okay, so we have seen the rice dishes, we have seen the madrua dishes. So this following dishes were mentioned in your art and culture website of Jharkhand. I have taken this dishes from that website only, and if further they will update any information, I will update it to you. Okay, so this was from the food section of Jharkhand. Now we will move to the ornament section of Jharkhand. Here I have given the link of the official website of Jharkhand Art and Culture. You can go and refer to that site. There are many information, and I think from the examination point of view, this website becomes very important. So I urge you that you visit this website and please go through it. Okay. And anything if you want to note important, you please note it down. Okay. So let's begin with the ornaments of Jharkhand. See, the first and the foremost ornament is Godana. Godana is basically Hindi version of tattooing. Okay, tattooing in Hindi is known as Godana. It is very famous with the tribal people of Jharkhand, as well as it is famous with the Sadan people. Now you must be wondering that who are Sadans? So Sadans are the non-tribals who have inhabited or who are living in Jharkhand from very early times. Okay, but they are non-tribals. Okay, so one, they are tribals, and the others, they are known as Sadans. They are the original inhabitants of Jharkhand, but they are not tribal people. They are known as Sadans. Then the second category of people, they are known as tribals. And one more category of people who reside in Jharkhand, they are known as Dikus. Now you must be wondering, who are Dikus? So Dikus are the people who are not original inhabitants of Jharkhand. They have migrated from some other place to the state of Jharkhand, and they are residing here. So they are known as Dikus. So you got three terminologies. One is Sadan, second is tribals, and the third is Dikus. Okay. In the subsequent lectures, we will study this categories of people in the state of Jharkhand. Don't you worry. Okay, so you got about Godana or tattooing. Second ornament we will look into are the headgears. What is a headgear? That is the ornaments which we wear on our head. Okay, so in that category we will see about khungso. Okay, just you have to remember the names, that a question may be asked to you in the examination that what is khungso, or it may be asked that what type of ornament is khungso, whether it is worn on the head or it is a hand jewelry or it is worn on your foot. So this type of things they will ask you, but they will don't ask you in much detail about khungso or that. So I will recommend you not to waste too much time into this detailing part. Just you mug up the fact that khungso is your headgear. Okay, so we have seen in headgear category we will see khungso, we will see chanwani or panpatta khungso. Okay, panpatta khungso. Then we have kalip. Then we have kalip. Okay, so these three category, these three ornaments are in the category of headgear. What are those? Khungso, chanwani or panpatta khungso, kalip. Okay, now we will see the ornaments which are worn in ear or ear jewelry. So in that category, we have Karan Phool, we have Kanpasa, we have Suparakana, okay, and we have Besari. So these four jewelries, they come in the category of ear jewelry. What are they? Karan Phool, Kanpasa, Suparakana, and Besari. See, in Hindi, we call ear as Kan. So from the name, that Karan Phool, we are getting Karan. Okay, Karan is Sanskrit terminology for ear. So Karan Phool, from that you will decipher that Karan Phool is a ear jewelry. Kanpasa, again a Kan is there. So you will be able to decipher that it is again a ear jewelry. Then we have Suparakana. Here also Kana is there. So from that also you will be able to decipher that it is a ear jewelry. And the last one is Besari. Besari, you have to remember this, that Besari is also a jewelry which is worn in ear. Okay. So you are clear with the ear jewelry. Now let's move forward with the jewelry that we wear in our neck or the necklaces. Okay. In this category, we should remember that Hasli comes under this category. Then we have Khambhia, it comes under this category. Then we have Sitahar under this category. We have Kanthamala under this category. And lastly, we have Chandrahar in this category. So see, these ornaments are also very easy to remember. Like see, first two you have to remember that Hasli and Khambhia, they are your necklaces or jewelry which are worn on our neck. Then from the third jewelry, that is Sitahar, Kanthamala and Chandrahar. See, Har is Hindi terminology for necklace and we wear Har on our neck. So Sitahar, Kanthamala and Chandrahar. See, Har is also known as Mala. So from the name only you will be able to decipher that, okay, Sitahar, Kanthamala and Chandrahar, they are the necklace or the jewelry which are worn on the neck. First two, that is Hasli and Khambhia, you have to remember. Okay, so it's very easy. One or two times if you mug up these things, no, it will become very easy for you. So let's go to the next category of jewelry. They are the handheld jewelry. Under handheld jewelry of Jharkhand, we will see Taad, then we have Baju Band, okay, then we have your Thela, we have Kangana, we have Bera, we have Behinkal, okay. So these are your handheld jewelry. So again we will repeat it once. It is Taad, it is Baju Band, then we have Thela, we have Kangana, we have Bera and Behinkal. Okay. See, some of the names you will be able to decipher from the terminology itself. Like, see, Baju Band. Baju. Okay. For shoulder, we use Baju. So from the name only, you will be able to decipher that it is a handheld jewelry. Then Kangana. Kangana or Kangan, we wear in our hands. Okay. From that only, you will be able to decipher. Then we have Thela. See, Thela is Hindi terminology for cart. Okay. So, the cart, we push it through our hands. So, if you get Thela, then you will be able to link like this and you will be able to decipher that, okay, it is a handheld jewelry. And some jewelries like Taad, Bera, Behinkal, you have to remember that they are handheld jewelry. That's why I am again telling you that read them or revise them 2-3 times and you will be able to mug this up. Okay, now we will go into the next category of footwear. Footwear, under the footwear category, we will see about payari, we will see about payal. Everyone knows about payal, that payal is a foot jewelry. Then we have Godram, we have Angutha, we have Jhatia, we have Katri, we have Bichhia. Okay, sorry, we have Bichhia. So these are your footwear jewelry. Again, we will revise once that under footwear category, we have Payari, we have Payal, we have Godram, we have Angutha, we have Jhatia, we have Katri, we have Bichhia. Okay, so I think jewelry portion of Jharkhand is clear to you. Just revise it and you will be able to remember it. Okay, so this was all for today's lecture. We have seen about the food of Jharkhand, we have seen the jewelry section of Jharkhand. Okay, and in the next lecture we will start some new topic from the art and culture portion of Jharkhand. We are left with significant portion from this topic, and I will try to upload the videos faster so that by the time notification comes out, we will be thorough with our portion of prelims examination. Okay, so that's all for today's lecture. We will meet again in the next lecture. Till then, read, revise and enjoy. Thank you.